There's a new web part in SharePoint. I'm going to break down what this new one is, why you want to use it, and how to configure all the options. Let's get into it. So the new web part is called the Editorial Card. What's the purpose of it? Well, it's really about presenting information in an eye-catching way. You have multiple options for it, including a call to action, but only if you want to use it. This thing kind of looks a lot like one of the tiles on the Hero web part. So if you want something like that, but you don't want the entire Hero, you just need a single card style layout so that it really, really pops out on the page and draws attention to it. This is what that's really designed for. It looks incredible, and I know you're going to love this thing. And as it's, this thing is really used when you want to make sure someone sees this content, period. It looks really good, and I hope it's a sign of things to come in terms of web parts in the future. Now, I'm going to show you how this looks and all the different section sizes and locations on the page, but first let's add this to the page and talk about how to configure this thing. So I'm on a basic site right now. I'm going to go into edit mode, and then we'll go down to, we can go down to this section with the three column layout on the section here. So we'll go in here. You could hit the plus button like you always could, or you could use the new content pane here, and you can search for the editorial card, and you'll see it right here. So if we drag this onto the page and then scroll over, you'll see kind of what this thing is. You'll be able to browse images. There's some options you'll have right inside here. But you'll really see all of the options a lot better if you just go to the web part properties. You'll see some options for the layout, the three layout options. I think more are going to come to this, I'm pretty sure. But you've got some options here for how this thing's going to look. It's already just the three out of the box options, how they look. It already looks really, really good, right? There's options to change the alignment of this, both vertical and horizontal. I kind of like the middle alignment all the way on the left side. But you'll also have options for what sort of a background. If you just want a colored background and not an image, you can do that. Or we can browse some of the images and pick something here. Now, once you get an image background, you'll still have other options. You can configure an overlay of a dark or a white color and then change the opacity. So if you want it to be more faded, have a kind of a darker look to it, then you can do that. If you want it to stand out more, you get options with how that image should kind of mesh with the text on top of it. You'll also see options here for a call to action. That's the button. So the call to action is if you want someone to take action based on this, you want someone to click a button to go read more about a particular piece of news or link off to a form, anything like that. If there's some action that you want someone to take and you want it to be really obvious that there is something they can do to go deeper with this piece of content, that's what the call to action is for. So you've got options to make a button, use an image, use text, or just make the entire card the call to action. So in other words, if they click anywhere inside that card, it'll take them to the link that you specify right here. And then if we switch back to button, if you type in something here, that's going to actually be the link or the button text. Let me change this right here. So now you'll see that the button is going to be visible. You'll know that because the text is darker. So if you don't have that, it's not going to have anything. If we were to just republish this right now, then you'll notice that the button isn't here because we didn't have a link to it. If there's no link, there's no reason for someone to click that button. So if we go back into the properties and we add the link back here, and republish, then you'll see that now the button is here. But we don't have any text on here. We see placeholders, but where do you put the text? Here's the cool part, and this is, I love when web parts use this type of functionality. All you have to do is click inside the web part, and now you can add in a category, something like news, and then you can type in whatever your headline should be, and then a description. So as you type in, if you type in just something in here and then you republish that, then you'll see what this thing is really going to look like. It looks really cool, right? It looks amazing. So let's just jump back into edit mode, because there's a lot of options with how you can present this. There's different ways it could look, but after the call to action, you'll have some accessibility options here. So what you can do here is describe, since we're using an image, describing what this image is here for. So if the image has some meaning, if it's describing something and you want screen readers to be able to read off the description of the image to low vision users or blind users, then that's where you're going to put this in. Otherwise, you can mark it as decorative, which means that the image is purely decorative. It doesn't have any context in relation to the news or the text on this web part itself. So you could mark that just so that the screen reader doesn't even acknowledge to the vision impaired user that there is an image here. So those are the basic options. But there's more you can actually do in here. If I click on the heading here, you'll notice that we've got some options for controlling this. We can control the style that the heading shows up in. The same with the description, but not the category. We can't change that, but we can customize a little bit how the font looks, the font size. If you click on the ellipsis button, you'll see some more options if we want it to be underlined, if we want it to be certain colors. There's a lot more here that you don't really notice unless you're starting to click around to see what all things are possible with this. You could change the line spacing if you've got multiple lines here. So there's the basic overview of all the options that you can configure this with this thing. But there's a page I've already put together showing how this looks in all of the different section sizes in SharePoint. But first, whether you're new to SharePoint or veteran, one thing is for certain, it's always changing, right? And you probably think it's really tough to keep up because it literally can change from one week to another, but not anymore. I've got a newsletter that'll keep you updated on all these features. Just click the link below to get signed up. It's free and it keeps you in the know with all things SharePoint. But now let's jump into our other page that has all of these different web parts configured in different sections. So on here, I've got different section sizes configured, and I've got a lot of different options configured for the editorial card. So you could kind of see what this is going to look like. Now, if I go into edit mode, then let me close the toolbar. You'll see I've got a one column section, two column, a three column. And you'll notice that even with the split option here, it looks really, really good where the image is on the top and then all the text is below. So if you want something that's a bit taller so that the image can stand on its own and then all the text content is below it, the split option is a really, really nice one. But I've also got the vertical section on here as well. So if you're using that vertical section and you want to throw some extra stuff, like maybe at the top of the page, so that it really catches the user's eye and makes your content really pop, then this is a good way. And this is also showing the icon style call to action as well. So in this example, let me just republish this. Now in this example, if I'm a user and I want to see more about this company all hands meeting, all I would have to do is click the learn more button and it takes me straight into the article because I've linked to this article in the call to action settings on the editorial card. So it's really, really simple. And the transition to the next page is also a very quick one. Now, there's so many new features in SharePoint, so many that I've dedicated a playlist just for SharePoint. So to get started, just click or tap the screen and I'll see you over there.